Today I'm going to show you the basic elements of a TWedge script and how to modify it. I've already configured TWedge as a keyboard wedge for a serial barcode scanner. If you run this configuration without any further modification, TWedge launches Notepad and transforms incoming barcode data into virtual keystrokes. The complete data acquisition logic is carried out by automatically generated JavaScript code, which works completely in the background and is totally invisible to the user. If required, such a script can be easily customized to meet even the most exotic requirements. All TWedge scripts follow the same principle. This header information is useful if a script serves as action template. It is usually followed by automatically generated code for the script parameters and the interface configuration. In this script, the properties for the serial port 3 are set. Most likely, you will go with the generated code, which is enclosed by these comments. If you scroll down, you'll see helper functions for opening, closing, and probably most important, for processing received device data. This function is customized if you need to modify the received device data, like adding prefix and postfix characters. We'll have a look at this in just a few minutes. There are also event handlers that are invoked when a device connection is started, a device connection was stopped, when device data is available for processing. Please note that this event calls the helper functions mentioned above. When a device connection has been lost or was interrupted, when a hotkey was pressed, or when a timer was triggered. You're free to modify the script as required to adjust the data acquisition logic. You're even free to change generated code sections. To avoid that TWedge overwrites changes to the generated code, remove the enclosing comments. Now let's change the default behavior of the script. I want to add a colon at the start and end of the received data. The right place for doing this is the process data helper function. Send keystrokes is responsible for forwarding the data to Notepad. It simulates keystrokes. The data appears as if manually typed by a user. This code replaces possible null values in the device data by spaces and also simulates the enter key. Let me add an extra colon at the beginning and at the end of it. Now check if the modification works as intended. What about adding a counter to each received barcode? This is easy as well. First, declare and initialize a counter variable with 0. Then add it at the beginning of the data. Don't forget to increment the counter variable. And now just try it out. Voila! The counter works perfectly. Scripting is easy, but a little understanding of JavaScript is required. Check out the manual and the scripting reference for details. And don't hesitate to contact TEC-IT support for free if you need help. Thanks for watching!